I'm Dan Kearnan, part of the SAP Business Technology Platform Marketing Team here live in Las Vegas at the SAP Insider event. And I'm joined with Amr from AWS. Amr, can you please introduce yourself?
Hey, Dan, it's great to be here. I'm Amr Elmeleegy with the SAP Specialist Organization at AWS.
Well, it's good to see you here at the SAP Insider event. So what brings AWS to Las Vegas this year?
So Dan, this is the first year that AWS sponsors an in-person SAP Insider event. However, we've been supporting SAP customers all the way since 2008. A little bit fun fact for our audience today, exactly 10 years ago here in Las Vegas, it was SAP Tech Ed, SAP announced SAP HANA 1. SAP HANA 1 was the first cloud deployment of HANA in-memory database in the cloud, and it was built on AWS, available on the AWS marketplace. If you remember back then, Dan, SAP customers, to get their hands on the HANA, had to spend between $30,000 to $40,000 to buy an on-premise HANA server. And there was only a handful of partners that were certified to offer it. We partnered with SAP to make that available for SAP customers for less than $1 an hour. So that was the introduction of SAP HANA on the cloud to a lot of SAP customers. So we've been partnering with SAP very long time ago.
Right. So yeah, AWS and SAP have a long history, especially as we entered the cloud market in introducing solutions with HANA. So yes, thanks for reminding me of that. I remember those years. So you've had probably lots of conversations with customers. In fact, there's been over 2,000 attendees at this event, and I've spoken to many of them. What are some of the conversations you've been having with the customers, with those attendees that have come by in your booth?
Absolutely. So a lot of customers attended the pre-conference day, and they sat through the RISE session during the pre-conference day. They heard about RISE. Some of them heard about RISE for the first time. And then they came to our booth to ask us questions about RISE. The first question they ask is, what happens to my SAP Bazes team? Do I need to maintain this team? Do I need to hire additional Bazes resources? What happens to my preferred partner? Will I need to select a new partner, or can I continue to work with my existing partner? And they also ask us questions about their non-SAP workloads. Can they move these non-SAP workloads to the cloud? And if they can't, how can AWS support them build integrations with their non-SAP and SAP RISE environments? So these are just some of the questions that a lot of SAP customers have been asking this
week. Well, that's because RISE is a hot topic right now. And one of the components of RISE is moving your ERP workloads to the cloud, which means you have to choose a cloud infrastructure provider. And knowing there's choices out there for our customers, for organizations, why AWS? What makes AWS a good cloud infrastructure provider when moving ERP workloads to the cloud?
Absolutely, Dan, great question. So there's a lot of similarities between AWS and SAP. SAP started the ERP market in the 70s and continue to be the number one market leader today, 50 years on. Congratulations on turning 50 years at SAP.
Right. It's our birthday.
Absolutely. So AWS shares a lot of similarities. SAP has the broadest scope of ERP out there in the market, continue to be the market leader 50 years on. Support the most number of languages and most number of countries. And that's why a lot of customers choose SAP ERP. Customers choose AWS for the same reason, Dan. We started the infrastructure as a service market in 2006 and continue to be the market leader today. We've been ranked as the market leader by Gartner 11 consecutive years in a row. We've been ranked by ISG as the HANA Cloud Platform Leader four years in a row. We offer the most secure, extensive, reliable cloud with 200 fully featured services across 86 availability zones and 26 regions. So that makes a lot of SAP customers interested in moving their SAP workloads onto AWS for the same reason they select SAP as well.
Yes, AWS has definitely been a front runner in the cloud storage infrastructure space. So good for AWS. But I can't not talk about RISE without also talking about SAP's business technology platform. And part of the reason for that is because to help you accelerate your ERP workloads to the cloud, SAP's many BTP services play a key role in that acceleration. And not only that, once that journey is complete, taking advantage and leveraging your investment in ERP and S/4HANA Cloud, BTP services play a key role in helping you do more extensive things, extensibility, and further getting more value out of your ERP environment. So tell me, what is the relationship between SAP's BTP services and AWS?
Absolutely. So we're very excited, first of all, about the SAP Business Technology Platform at AWS. A little bit fun fact for the audience today, AWS offers the widest selection of business technology platform services compared to any other cloud service provider and in the most number of regions. In fact, there are 30 business technology platform services that are only supported or only built on the AWS cloud platform. I'll give you some examples then about some of these services. SAP App Giver that allows SAP customers after they move to the cloud to build low-code, no-code extension solutions. This capability is built only on the AWS cloud. For customers that prefer to use the ABAP language to build these extensions and side-by-side scenarios, they can use the ABAP environment on BTP that's built on AWS. 11 of the 12 AI, ML, IoT, and RPA business technology platform services are built only on the AWS cloud. So we're very excited about supporting SAP customers' journey and helping them use the SAP BTP as sort of that first extensibility and innovation layer as they extend their ERP environments and then consume additional AWS native services to help more innovation and with their digital transformation journey.
Well, judging by how many customers have made the choice in moving ERP to the cloud on AWS, in addition to the many BTP services they've chosen, it shows that that's a winning combination. So let's, kind of in a wrap-up note, what message would you like to leave, any last-minute remarks you would like to leave to a customer, to an organization who's on their journey or thinking to move their ERP workloads to the cloud and want to maybe consider AWS?
Absolutely. One of the things that we can help SAP customers with is connect them to any one of our 5,000-plus customers that have trusted AWS with their SAP workloads. We have many customers that move their SAP ECC environments, S4HANA environments, BW4HANA environments, as well as RISE environments. One example is Manchester Airport Group. They operate 4 airports in the United Kingdom. They moved RISE on AWS, and we help customers connect to customers like this so they can hear directly from them about their RISE journey. So I encourage any customer that is interested in learning more about RISE and connecting with other similar customers to reach out to us, because that's what we help customers with.
And on that note, for those that want to learn more about SAP's business technology platform, go to sap.com/BTP. Lots of information there. So Amer, thanks. It's been great, very insightful. Good to meet with you again. And I hope we have a great rest remaining part of the conference.
Thank you very much, Ben.